Welcome out, Music Central. We're hanging out here tonight in the country music tent, Savari Tent, with this young lady right here. And I know a lot of y'all know her. You see her around Facebook, in and off the stages, opening for all kinds of different acts. Please welcome Miss Katie Mack. How you doing, Katie?
I'm great. How are you?
Awesome. We're glad to be here tonight. Let's talk a little bit about the tent, the Savari Tent.
The Savaris are actually my cousins. So when you're here, make sure you buy food from them and beer, and it'll make me look good.
And a little bit about the history. This has been like one of the longest running tents here, right?
Yeah. My Uncle Edgar, who's like 80-something now, he had this back when he was young. So, yeah, it's been around for a while.
Awesome. Well, we're glad to have you here tonight. And it's really hot in here. Like, it was cool.
Horrible. I've been sweating so bad.
It was cool till Katie took the stage, and then she just raised the temperature about 80 degrees. So we are. It's a little warm in here tonight. Let's talk about your all-star band. Introduce your band and all that.
All right. I got B.G. Johnson as my bass player. I got Tommy Monahan as my rhythm player. Phil Abel as my lead guitar player. And then we have D.C. Dave Carter on drums. And I'm glad Dave came because love him. We think alike, so I like him. And he came all the way back from Massachusetts to play with me. So.
Yeah, that means a lot. I mean, that's great. Like, when I saw the band, I was like, wow, how did she do that?
Just knowing people, being sweet.
That's true. You are awesome. You're really awesome. And let's talk a little bit about, you had a great contest going on. You posted it all over Facebook to help you get votes for the WAMZ. Let's talk a little bit about that contest.
Okay, so I entered a competition through WAMZ, and the top three people were chosen. It was me, a girl from Georgia, and a girl from Florida. And it was by the number of votes that you got, and I ended up winning, and I got to sing with really big people from Nashville, including Hillary James, who's like a huge, huge person for, like she writes a lot of songs for Carrie Underwood, and then I got to sing with Brett James. Hillary Lindsay's her name, excuse me. And I got to sing with Brett James, who's really big, and he's Kip Moore's producer, so.
Awesome, we love Kip, he's great.
I know, he's cute, I saw him last night.
Well, did you tell him hi for me?
I will. I got backstage, he got me drinks, so it was awesome.
We love you, man. And also, too, you got a CD out.
I do. It has 6 original songs, so buy one.
Awesome. And then tell people how they can find you.
You can find me on Facebook. You can find me on my Facebook page is facebook.com/KatieMcD. And then Instagram, it's KatieMac40. And Twitter, it's KatieMac40. So follow me. Like me on Instagram.
Definitely. You got to like this lady. We're going to have a great performance for you. We actually got some live video up here on the TV right now, hanging out in the Savari tent. We'll be here all week long at the State Fair, thanks to Katie Mack and her family. This is Paul Taylor hanging out with Music Central.
So you're in the market for a new television for your home. Have you been to Bonnie Castle lately? At Bonnie Castle Appliance and TV, we only carry the best name brands like Toshiba, Mitsubishi, LG, and Sharp. And our service, we can't be beat. Being a member of the nation's largest buying group, we offer you a better deal than any of the big box stores in town. When it comes to televisions, you've got to make Bonnie Castle Appliance and TV your first choice. There's no hassle at Bonnie Castle.
There's a mobile movement going on. The rise of smartphones is creating smarter consumers, creating more opportunity for smarter marketing. Smartphones are always on, always with us, and always connected. In 1 week, we've browsed the internet, used a search engine, watched a video, and connected with our friends, all on our smartphones. But that's info you might already know. Here's some you might not. We're using smartphones almost everywhere, even while consuming other media. Smartphones have become such an important part of our lives that many of us would give up high heels, cable TV, even chocolate, just to keep using them. They're becoming important to our shopping habits, too. Smartphones have become the ultimate shopping companion, transforming us into more savvy consumers. 79% use a smartphone to help with shopping. In fact, 70% of us actually use our smartphone while in the store. We use it to find retailers, compare prices, get coupons, read reviews, and check to see if something's in stock. Which leads us to buy. Nearly 3/4 of shoppers made a purchase as a direct result of the info we got from our smartphones, either in store, online, or on our phone. Our new mobile shopping habits are adding up to big spending across the board. And where do we do most of our shopping? Usually in our own backyards. In fact, finding local information is one of the most popular smartphone activities. We're using our phones to find everything from the nearest pizza place to movie showtimes to finding the nearest store that carries the item we're looking for. And 88% of us use that local information and take action within a day, whether to call or visit a local business. Over the past year, mobile search queries have skyrocketed to new heights as we search for everything from product reviews to travel info to random trivia that can help us settle bets with our friends. And while word of mouth or seeing a product in store may lead people to search on smartphones, 71% of us search because we saw an ad, both on traditional media and on our phones, and we're acting on it. 9 out of 10 mobile users have taken action all thanks to a smartphone search. The simple fact is, mobile ads work. Recall seeing a mobile ad? You're not alone. 82% of us do. Yet 79% of top advertisers don't have a mobile-optimized website. It's important to build a good mobile user experience because if we see a mobile ad, we tend to click on the ad, visit the advertiser's site, make a purchase, or call the business. Today we use smartphones to stay connected, to keep us entertained, to search for information on the go, and to make us smarter shoppers. And we're going to be doing a lot more of this, creating more opportunities for marketers to connect with their customers. Don't miss the mobile movement. Mobilize your marketing to reach the new smartphone consumer.
Hi, I'm David Payne with Tire Store at Your Door. Do you find that going to the store to buy tires a burden? Then let me show you why we are called Tire Store at Your Door. Check us out online at tirestoreatyourdoor.com or just call 502-639-3895. Tire Store at Your Door, the most convenient tire store you'll ever do business with.
Hey, welcome out, Music Central. We're hanging out here tonight at the Kentucky State Fair 2013. And if you can tell, we're backstage with Montgomery Gentry and J.D. Shelburne, courtesy of Jim Beam. We want to thank the Jim Beam guys. We're going to get a great interview with J.D. Shelburne coming right up. Stay tuned. Hey, welcome out, Music Central. Again, we're backstage at the State Fair, courtesy of Jim Beam. And also this guy right here. You've seen him around town, a Louisville legend, Mr. J.D. Shelburne. How you doing tonight?
Good to see you again, man. How we doing?
It is awesome. J.D. and I have had some wonderful times on and off buses. It's been crazy, but we've always followed JD. He's a marketing guru. He's a great musician, and we're glad to be here tonight. And let's talk about tonight.
Yes, sir.
Opening for Eddie Montgomery, or Montgomery Gentry, actually.
Yeah, it's unreal, man. You know, I've been playing the tent, the Savoy tent, for the last 5 years, and this year they graduated me to the big stage, man. I was told my friends it's surreal to drive by on 65 going back to Nashville and seeing my name on the board with some of the greatest, you know. So it's been one heck of a ride, and it's just you know, I've got the greatest fans that you know, that have gotten me here. You know, it's all about fans, and every year my career just keeps excelling more and better gigs, bigger things, and this is one of them. This is the biggest gig of my career tonight, so I'm ready to bust it, man.
Well, and that's true. We have followed you. You're a marketing guru. You're a wonderful musician. You've built that fan base one fan at a time, getting to know each and every fan. Let's talk a little bit about how personal you are with your fans.
You know, it's all about my fans. I think that's kind of where I stand different from other artists. You know, I sit back and watch Garth Brooks for years, Kenny Chesney, some of the best. And, you know, I heard Garth Brooks say he waited in line or would sign autographs at Fanfare for 14 hours. I'm like, that's something I would do. You know, I mean, fans are what keep you going. You know, they're what's buying your merch. They're building your house, you know, and my fans have just been great, man. You know, it's just one of those things where I think our music's current. We play, you know, our writing, I think, has gotten better. Our songs are easy to remember. So I just think, you know, just from day one, like I said, the very first fan 10 years ago to what I've got now, it's all because it's Twitter, Facebook. You know, I run all that myself. You know, I always try to make time for fans. That even if I'm out to eat and I'm not playing a show and I see fans, I always make time to talk and hug. So that's what it's all about.
Absolutely. And another thing I want to commend you on is, you know, we do a TV show and we do a weekly thing. I've noticed that you do a lot of weekly stuff on YouTube.
I do a thing called Couch Sessions. It's something one of my fans kind of gave me an idea and I ran with it. And what I do is on Facebook, I'll put usually 2 to 3 songs, cover, original, just depends on kind of what my mood is. And we'll have the fans vote on what they want to hear. In the winter, each week, I'll perform it in my living room at home. And it's just, man, I'm getting 20,000 views. I mean, it's just, you know, people are sharing it and they're sharing it and they're sharing it. So it's just kind of, it's something different. Just get more fans on my website. And we'll try it for a while. We'll probably try something different in the next couple months. But it's working right now, so we're sticking with it.
Okay, now, we talked about you being here tonight, and that is an awesome opportunity. But you got a lot of great stuff coming up. Let's talk about your upcoming stuff.
Got a lot of good stuff coming up. We're still doing a lot of festivals. That's something I've really stuck to the last 4 or 5 years. I mean, that's where most of your fans come out. It's free. All ages can come. You know, we're doing the Gaslight Festival in September. We're going to West Palm Beach in October. I do a lot of acoustic shows, man. I don't have to bring the whole band. It's kind of more intimate. You know, I can play a lot more requests and stuff like that. We're playing Manny and Merle's coming up. I play there once a month in Louisville. It's a great venue downtown off Main Street. Just a bunch of stuff. I can't even think what I got coming up, man. Just all sorts of stuff. We got about another 40 dates this year, and it's 2014. So looking forward to next year. And I never thought this time last year I'd be here, you know, so it's just the Lord works in mysterious ways, and he's got me here, and my fans too, so I'm waiting for the Opry call.
That'll be awesome. And the good news is you don't have to remember where you are because it's always posted on Facebook, and you have a website, right?
It's jdshelburn.com. Also got facebook.com/jdshelburn, Twitter. Most people say, how do you spell your last name? It's Shelburne. So check it out. You know, you fans, just it's all about fans. New fans, you've never heard me play before, come out and see us live. You know, our stuff's on iTunes right now. We got a music video out. So things are rocking in our camp, and we're blessed.
Well, I'm excited about this, bud.
Thinking back when I was a kid, doing all the things my granddad did. Never thought it'd be this hard to feel this. All that wisdom under granddad's hat, wishing like hell I'd remember all that. Learned everything I know from that old man. Before he died, he gave me the keys and said, son, this is how you'll remember me. When you fire up the tractor, it cuts right through where we'd sow our crops. That rusted windmill stopped turning the other day. And that farmhouse granddad built with his hands still stands strong on this old farmland. His roots run deep, they're forever here to stay. Still got the barn, and it's got the plow. Granddad always said that's what this life is all about. When I fire up the tractor, roll in the hay, light up the bonfire at the end of the day, take a swing from mama's mason jar. I ain't scared to work, that's how I was raised. Live by the Bible and taught. I'm an F.A.R.
Imagine a consumer. He's on his smartphone a lot these days. He's walking downtown when he whips out his phone to find a business. Yours. But when he taps your link, he gets a site that clearly wasn't designed for a mobile device. It's too hard to use, so he gives up. Or worse yet, goes to your competitor, who has already made a mobile-friendly site. You see, mobile users are looking for sites that work for them. And with mobile usage growing by leaps and bounds, this means a lot of new opportunities to reach your customers. That's why we're introducing GOMO, a Google initiative to help businesses make mobile-friendly sites. Everything you need is available at howtogomo.com. Learn about how your customers use mobile and what they want from a mobile site. Discover our 10 best practices for mobile sites and how to incorporate them. Use our GOMO meter to test your site and get personalized recommendations. And connect with a mobile site developer who can help you build your site now and turn this to this. More clicks, more customers, more conversions. The future is in your hand. Visit GOMO today, mobilize your site, and move your business forward.
Mobile is transforming our lives in almost every way, connecting our physical and digital worlds. Smartphones are driving an explosion of the mobile web, and mobile search along with it. Mobile is so big, it's changing and creating new consumer behaviors. Mobile is entertaining us in new ways. Mobile is extremely local. Mobile is the ultimate shopping companion. Mobile is enabling us to immediately take action, even when we're far from home. People are searching for everything, and at rates worth noting. Your consumers are on mobile. As a marketer, you need to be on mobile too. Here are five ways to use mobile to your advantage. Build a mobile site that's relevant and easy to use. Make it easy for people to take action. Create an experience that's useful and unique to mobile. Learn from how your customers interact with your site and adapt your experience accordingly. Make mobile part of your marketing plan. Mobile isn't a trend, it's a new era. And it's not too late to be early.
Hi, I'm David Payne with Tire Store at Your Door. Do you find that going to the store to buy tires a burden? Then let me show you why we are called Tire Store at Your Door. Check us out online at tirestoreatyourdoor.com or just call 502-639-3895. Tire Store at Your Door, the most convenient tire store you'll ever do business with.
Make your dreams taste better with new kitchen appliances from Bonnycastle. Bonnycastle has a bigger selection, more styles, and more quality brand names to choose from than ever before. Dramatically increase the value of your home with a kitchen upgrade from Bonnycastle. Now even gourmet chefs are finding their favorite home appliances at Bonnycastle with top-of-the-line brands like Asco, Bosch, Thermador, Miele, GE Monogram, Sub-Zero, and Wolf.
Best selection, custom installation, and best price. Come see us. There's no hassle at Bonnycastle.
Well, I'm excited about this bus, man. It's a step up from the Explorer.
Oh, man. It's like going from a Pinto to a Cadillac, man. You know, it's a lot nicer. I didn't have to drive, you know, so everything's good. And, I just like to play music, man. And if fans want to listen, I would all of them.
Well, you do, and it shows in your music that you love to do what you do, and when you do what you love and love what you do, you become a success.
That's what I hear, you know, and I'm from a small town, and, I played sports growing up. You know, I was just all about, never being arrogant to people, you know, and I think just some artists I've played for, you know, through the past, you know, I see arrogance, and I see fans that walk away and throw their CDs down, and I've seen it all in music, you know, playing these festivals and being around other artists, and I just learned the hard way that, you know, you have to, no matter how many fans come up to you and want to talk to you, you have to give them time, you know, and that's, I think I just got patience, you know, but I'm from a small town. I grew up around a lot of small town people. I'm just a good old country boy, man, with a guitar in front of me and a few fans. And things are just happening, and I'm loving it and looking forward to it. So,
and that's true, and I'll second that as well. We are going to move out of the way real quick because Eddie Montgomery's bus is coming in. And wow, look at that.
I bet you Eddie don't wax it.
No. I guarantee that. I guarantee that. Well, man, that has been an awesome interview. We look forward to a great performance tonight. I love this bus. It's just gorgeous right here.
Gotta pick the bugs off of it a little bit.
We're hanging out backstage with J.D. Shelburne. Check him out on his website. Check him out on Facebook. Like him on Facebook. This is going to air this coming Thursday. Awesome.
Sense into you. Well, I'm going up Cripple Creek, going at a run, going up Cripple Creek to have a little fun. Tall man said they found some tracks, people saw them leaving, but they never come back.
Hi, I'm David Payne with Tire Store at Your Door. Do you find that going to the store to buy tires a burden? Then let me show you why we are called Tire Store at Your Door. Check us out online at tirestoreatyourdoor.com or just call 502-639-3895. Tire Store at Your Door, the most convenient tire store you'll ever do business with.
So you're in the market for a new television for your home. Have you been to Bonnie Castle lately? At Bonnie Castle Appliance and TV, we only carry the best name brands like Toshiba, Mitsubishi, LG, and Sharp. And our service, we can't be beat. Being a member of the nation's largest buying group, we offer you a better deal than any of the big box stores in town. When it comes to televisions, you've got to make Bonnie Castle Appliance and TV your first choice. There's no hassle at Bonnie Castle.
I'm going to sit here and make you look good.
Hey, welcome out, everybody. We're backstage tonight. Kentucky State Fair 2013. Ah, you know these guys, a dynamic duo right here, Montgomery Gentry. Hey, Eddie, welcome to Louisville.
Hey, my brother, I'm telling you, it's Kentucky, baby. We're home, baby. We're home, and we can't wait. Everybody's crazy. They're just now starting to get crazy. Look out. It's getting ready to rock. Look out. I heard plenty of Jim Beam is flowing, baby.
Yeah, I heard there was a few people out front. I don't know. What do you think?
Well, I'll tell you what. I know if there's anything like it is backstage right now, it's going to be wild as hell.
Well, we love you. You know,
I think we got just as many people backstage as we do out there.
That is true. It's a party back here. And, hey, I want to tell you something about these guys, man. I love them. They support a lot of local causes here. They do the Barnstable Brown Party.
Oh, yes, most definitely, man. Derby, of course, everything, man. Me and T, being born and raised in Kentucky, man. Kentucky's in our blood, and, we're very proud of it no matter where we go.
Faster horses and better bourbon.
Well, I think it's always, what is it, fast women and beautiful horses.
There you go.
And unbelievable Jim Beam.
Hey, I want to give a special announcement to this guy right here. You know, I was down there at the George Jones funeral. Let's talk a little bit about George Jones a minute. What an awesome legend to country music.
So anyways,
so I'm down there, and all of a sudden I'm doing great, and then this guy gets on stage. Y'all get on stage, and you do the song, Who's Gonna Fill These Shoes?
Yeah,
dude, awesome. I lost it.
Uh-
Man, we had a bad day today. We've lost a great human being here in country music. And, you know, our house had a lot of George Jones in it. My dad was a big George Jones fan, and I'm going to try to do a song tonight. It was one of my dad's favorites. I sat around the kitchen table all day long working on this song. So I hope I do it justice tonight. And, man, if y'all want to jump in and sing along with us, please do. You're more than welcome to. Go something like this right here.
I tell you, we grew up a bunch singing George Jones. He was the man.
You know this old world was full of singers, but just a few were chosen to tear your heart out when they sing. Imagine life without them. All the radio heroes, like the outlaw that walks through Jesse's dream. No, there'll never be another red-headed stranger, a man in black and full of prison blue. The Yogi from Muskogee, hello, darling. Lord, I wonder who's gonna fill their shoes. Who's gonna fill their shoes? Who's gonna stand up tall? Who's gonna play the Opry and the Wabash Cannonball? Who's gonna give their heart and soul to get to me and you? Lord, I wonder who's gonna fill their shoes? God bless the boys from Memphis, blue suede shoes and Elvis. Much too soon he left his world in tears. They tore up the 50s, old Jerry Lee and Charlie. Go, cat, go, still echoes through the years. You know the heart of country music still beats in Luke the Drifter. You can tell when he sings, I saw the light. Old Parson Marty, Hank and Lefty, well, I can feel him right here with me on the Silver Eagle. This rolling down tonight. Who's gonna fill his shoes? Who's gonna stand up tall? Who's gonna play the opera?
I'll tell you, man, it's been unbelievable how great George and Nancy, man, have both been to us. And, you know, of course, there's a TV show coming up in November, and so we're going to be lucky enough to be part of that. And I miss him every day, man. And I tell you what, no matter where you're going to be at, if there's a radio on, you're going to hear some Jones, baby.
Well, we love these guys right here, the dynamic duo. Montgomery Gentry, Eddie and Troy in the house. We hope you enjoy the show tonight. We'll see you soon.
Gonna miss you, Possum. Get up for some lovely singers back here tonight. Thank you all so much.
There's a story that my daddy tells religiously, like clockwork every time he sees an opening in a conversation about the way things used to be. Well, I'd just roll my eyes and make a beeline for the door, but I'd always end up starry-eyed, cross-legged on the floor, hanging on to every word. Man, the things I heard. It was harder times and longer days, 5 miles of school uphill both ways. We were cane switch raised, dirt floor poor. Of course, that was back before the war. Yeah, your uncle and I made quite a pair, flying F-15s through hostile air. He went down, but they missed me by hair. He'd always stop right there and say,
that's something. proud of. That's a life you can hang your hat on. That's a chin held high, the tear fall down. Gut sucked in, chest stuck out like a small town flag of flying. Or a newborn baby crying. In the arms of the woman that you love. That's something to be proud of.
A son graduating college, that was mama's dream. But I was on my way to anywhere else when I turned 18. Cause when you got a fast car, you think you got everything. I learned quick those GTOs don't run on faith. And I ended up broken down in some town north of LA, working maximum hours. Or minimum wage. Well, I fell in love, next thing I know, babies came, the car got slow. Sure do miss that old hot rod. Sure save gas in them foreign jobs. Dad, I wonder if I ever let you down. If you're ashamed how I turned out. Well, he lowered his voice, then he raised his brow. Said, let me tell you right now.
That's something to